Hello, I'm Sauki, and today I'm doing this Velomobile road trip. And here's my Quest Velomobile, and I'm going to ride with this to our summer cottage in Manamansalo, which is about, today's road is going to be about 250 kilometers. So here I'm getting ready for the ride, and yesterday I made some maintenance. I did have to adjust the brakes, I washed the visor, and I made some small adjustments, like this was a little bit loose, and I lubricated the chain and stuff like that. Check the tire pressure and so on. So now the Quest should be ready for the ride. I want to ride with the racing hood because it's not so hot today, and it's a little bit faster with the racing hood, or more efficient. Okay, so here I have a lot of stuff going on. I have something to drink here, 3 liters of water, and there's more water, and this is a this kind of sports drink called Heart Sport. There's my camera gear, there's something to eat, and there in this bag there's more stuff to eat and some other things. Then I took these new cleats with me because the cleats on my shoes are pretty much worn out, so I don't know if they can hold this trip. And then I have shoes, or yeah, sandals, if I have to walk. And then here I have some spare tires, and the pump is over there. And in this bag there's some tools and spare tires and stuff that keeps me going, or stuff that keeps the Velomobile going. These are the stuff that keeps me going. Yes, here's my bike computer, and I have saved the route here, even though I pretty much know the route, but it's still nice to have a map so I can check how much is still to go. But anyway, I just have to go and change my clothes and go to bathroom, and then I think that I'm ready to go. So the road is ready here, 246 kilometers to go, so let's go! Okay, so the plan is to ride to Manamansalo today, 246 kilometers. I have done this many times before, but this time I have a little bit different road. I do have enough food and water with me, so basically I don't need to stop anywhere, but I'm probably going to make few stops, but let's see. And my plan here for today is to try to eat so that I don't feel hungry when I finish at our summer cottage, because then I have been eating just the right amount. Okay, I was lazy and didn't use my external microphone during the rest of this journey, so the audio is going to be pretty bad. So I decided to make this voice over. Okay, so here I turn to this highway. I'm going to stay on this road for the next 200 kilometers or so. There is this annoying rumble strip for the first 35 kilometers, but the shoulder should be wide enough for my Quest. Now I'm arriving to Kannus. I've been cycling about 26 kilometers, but I already had 2 B stops, so I'm not going to stop for a break here. Here I'm explaining that I travel quite lightly. I have only the most essential stuff with me, which you already saw at the beginning of this video. My wife and the kid are coming behind me with the car, and they have the rest of my stuff. Okay, there's this resting area on top of this little hill. I think I need to stop for a pee. Yes, I have to stop again. This is few kilometers after Kannus. I can still feel in my legs the last weekend's ride with Tero. I was going pretty fast. Now let's try this
this sports drink. I've never tried this hard sport before. Okay, pretty nice. But I have a little problem. I can't drink this while riding because, well, I have to do this. And there's no room for this under the racing hood. So I can only drink this while stopped. But okay, let's continue to Sievi.
Here I'm very happy that the Rumble Strips ends here. And now I'm arriving Sievi, and I have been riding 56 kilometers so far, so less than 200 to go, and I decided to have a break again.
I bought a Snickers because these protein bars, these are not so tasty. Everyone is buying more fuel because tomorrow the gas price will go up in Finland.
Here I'm explaining that it's 24 kilometers to Nivala and I want to have a break over there again because the next stretch is a little bit longer and I should eat something else than protein bars. So I'm planning on buying a sandwich or something. There is this very nice new asphalt between Sievi and Nivala. Very nice to ride with Velomobile on this brand new and smooth asphalt.
Okay, just a quick pit stop here. I just want to attach this camera on top of the Velomobile. So you can see if I crash in the next downhill.
And here's the downhill. I wanted to try a new speed record on this nice smooth asphalt. Look at the speedometer. 93 kilometers per hour. I actually ran out of gears much earlier, but I just tried to keep up with the cadence. It's not very convenient to try to keep this high 150 rpm cadence. When I left Sievi, I forgot to turn my headlights back on. I didn't realize it until after this. I guess it would have been easier for the lady to notice me if I had my lights on. And now I'm in Nivala, and I'm going for a break again. By the way, I have to say it was the best idea ever to take these extra shoes with me. So much nicer to walk with these than with my cycling shoes. I bought some sandwich and some juice.
Okay, so now I'm in Nivala and I have been riding 83 kilometers and there's still 164 kilometers to go.
And I have already spent almost 1 hour for breaks. Now that I'm watching this later, that's actually pretty ridiculous. Way too much brakes. But anyway, the next place is Kärsämäki in 41 kilometers and I'm going to have a break over there as well.
Shit, I have to stop because I didn't feel my back over here. But I put it over there. was so far away that I couldn't reach it. I thought that I forgot it back in Nivala. But okay, no problem, let's continue.
Here I'm again happy to see more of this brand new asphalt. From here it's 20 kilometers to Kärsämäki, and in this point I have been riding about 106 kilometers, and I've been traveling 3 hours and 50 minutes. And I also started to realize that I have been moving only 3 hours, so I've had about 50 minutes of breaks, which is way too much. Here's another fast downhill. This time I didn't want to break any speed records, just cruising down the hill at almost 80 km per hour. And here is Kärsämäki. I'm supposed to continue in that direction on the same highway, but instead I'm having this little detour to this place where I want to stop for a break. Again. I stopped counting how many times I've stopped during this first half of the ride.
No nyt on keskinopeus ollut 35, aika sillä rauhalliseen tahtiin. Tuossa Nivalassa oli semmonen, siinä on vähän ennen Nivalaa semmonen kiva alamäki, niin 92 oli huiput. 93 taisi olla. 93.1, joo.
Okay, you got the idea. A lot of interested people asking stuff. These stops just take too much time. Okay, back on the route again. Next place is Pyhäntä after 31 kilometers. Let's see if I stop over there again. I was listening some music, so it wasn't so boring to ride this long and boring stretch in the middle of nowhere. And now I'm in Pyhäntä. There's this new shopping center type of thing over there, but I decided not to stop over there. It should have been nice to check the place though. I haven't been there before. But I've had too many stops already, so better just keep going.
I'm going to stop for a pee. I could have stopped in Pyhäntä in that new shopping center or what the hell was it? But I decided to stop here.
I bought this sandwich from Kärsämäki, so time to eat. There's going to be the longest uphill of today ahead. And on top of the hill, I decided to have a quick break and stretch my legs a little bit. But just a quick break and then back on the road again. At this point, I have been running 186 kilometers. And then it's downhill all the way to this intersection, where I have to turn towards Vuolijoki. This little road is actually pretty nice. Nice to have a little change to this straight highway. And now I'm in Vuolijoki. Time to have first proper break after Kärsämäki. This is about 208 kilometers from the start, so it's about 80 kilometers from Kärsämäki. So really good place for a break. I went to a grocery store and bought something to drink and a sandwich. It was actually a great idea. I felt a bit tired before Vuolijoki and my left knee started to hurt about 1 hour ago. After I ate the sandwich, I felt much better and the knee pain was gone as well. And now starts the race against time. Manamansalo is an island in the middle of a big lake. And to get to the island from this side of the lake, you have to use this ferry. Ferry goes over every half an hour. I want to get to the ferry so that I don't have to wait half an hour for the next one. So now I have about 25 kilometers to go to the ferry and about 45 minutes of time. Should be doable. And now I'm in this intersection. From here there is 5 kilometers to go and I have about 30 minutes of time before the ferry leaves. So no problem. And here I am at the ferry with few minutes extra time. There is this big truck which is not going to fit to this ferry because there is already a lot of cars on board. So he's going to wait. And I'm looking here if there happens to be room for one velomobile. And the ferry captain signals me that yes, there is room. So let's get on board. Very good timing, by the way.
Great timing.
The ferry leaves right after I'm on board. Okay, so there's only about 17 kilometers to go. So let's look at the stats of this ride. It took me a total of 9 hours to get here, but the moving time was only 7 hours and 17 minutes. So I had way too many and too long breaks. But I don't feel hungry. In fact, I feel very good about this. And that actually was the main goal here today. That means that I did eat just enough so I don't feel hungry. But anyway, Strava claims my average speed was 34.5 km per hour, which is not so bad. But this was good practice. I have been mostly riding my 25 km commute, so I think that's why it takes some time to get used to this long distance cycling. But anyway, I still have to ride back home after a few days, but that's going to be another video.
But okay, I think that's enough for this video. Thanks for watching and please remember to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already, and also check my webshop and buy something. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.